Hey everybody, been a long time since I've done a Play Dirty episode, so let's do one just before GenCon. It's kind of a prep for my theme at GenCon this year for my big Play Dirty versus Robin Law's cage match of Doom. And the whole theme that I'm going for is that being a game master is a lot like being a magician. Both the professions have a lot in common, and well, to illustrate my point, I'd like to do a magic trick. So, what I'd like you to do is, here we go, pick a card, any card. Go ahead, pick one. Pick one of the cards I'm holding up, and make sure that you remember the card that you want, okay? Do you have the card you want? Memorize the card you want, all right? This is your card. Excellent. Now, think about it. Keep it in your mind. Now, I'm going to make your card disappear. But first, I need to read your mind. So what I need you to do is put your hand out and put it on the screen. Go ahead and put it on the screen. Go ahead and do that. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to read your mind. I'm reading your mind. What card did you pick? Which card did you pick? Aha. All right, now I'm going to hold up the set of cards again, and I want you to look for your card. You ready? Here we go. Did I take your card out of the set? Presto. So that trick's really easy to do, and with a little bit of Google searching, you can figure out how to do it. But that's true about most Game Master tricks, too. The whole point of the Game Master is using tricks to make players believe in things that aren't there, or to believe in things that are impossible, or to believe in things that are invisible. When we were designing Legend of the Five Rings, one of the key events of the first storyline was the death, the ritual suicide, of the Lion Clan champion. And there was some resistance from Lion Clan players, especially Dave Williams, when we first proposed the idea. He said that Lion Clan players, and he didn't just say it, Dave was honestly upset. And for 10 minutes, he talked about every reason that he, as a player, would be upset and about the game if we killed the Lion Clan champion. He was very passionate. He was very honest. He was very sincere. And at the end of that 10 minutes, we all agreed that Dave's reaction was exactly why we should do it. We had created a character in the setting that players loved so much that they would have an emotional response to something so negative happening to the character. And making someone feel emotion about a little piece of paper, about something that doesn't exist, is every game master's job. It's your job to make your players believe in the world that you're selling them. And like a magician pulling a rabbit out of a hat or playing with cards, your job is to make them believe in something that their rational mind knows isn't real. I did my little bit about reading your mind, and of course I don't have any kind of mental powers, but that's the whole point of the trick, is that at the reveal, at the end, for a brief moment, you believe that I used some kind of mentalism to read your mind. Even if it's just for a microsecond, that's fine. Because that's my job as a game master, is to make you, the player, believe in something that doesn't exist. That's impossible to believe. That's my job. How do I do that? How do I get my players to believe in things, in characters that don't exist, in people that don't exist, in places that don't exist? You've got to infuse them with an authenticity that makes your players believe in them. Now, as human beings, we're equipped with the tools to do that, both as the game master and the player. As a game master, if you study the tricks of con men, you study the tricks of actors, you study the tricks of filmmakers, you study the tricks of any kind of storyteller, you will learn how to tap into people's emotions and pull them to the surface. Psychologically, human beings are equipped with this ability. We do it unconsciously. We do it all the time. For example, I'm going to tell you about a friend of mine. His name is Jesse, and Jesse F. And Jesse is one of the nicest guys I know. He's just a sweet fella. And he's got kids, and he looks after them. He's the most responsible parent that I think, one of the most responsible parents I've ever met. Hi, Hiram and Annie, you guys are great too. He's just a really great dad. And sometimes he has to be mean, and sometimes he has to be stern, but he's just a fantastic dad. He's also a big GURPS fan, and he does amazing things in his games. Now, the reason I'm telling you about Jesse is because right now, in your mind, you're beginning to form a picture of him. How tall he is. What the color of his hair. Does he have a beard? Does he have glasses? What kind of clothes does he wear? How does he talk? How does he walk? What kind of, you know, you're already in your mind developing a mental picture of Jesse. That's because we are a race of storytellers. We are designed to receive stories. We're designed to receive information and to create mental images and conclusions just by the process of hearing that information. As a game master, knowing this one fact, knowing just this, is an important first step in getting your players to believe in things that don't exist. Knowing how we receive information and knowing how we draw conclusions from it will help you draw images and people and places that will compel your players to come back again and again and again and again. Because we're not just game masters. We are magicians. We're creating things that don't exist and getting people to believe it. That's my pitch. So, this Gen Con, come and listen to me and Robin Laws talk about game mastering techniques. It'll be a lot of fun, and I'm really looking forward to it, because Robin is a great guy, and although I've never played any of his games, hint, perhaps Robin and I can arrange something. Anyway, it's almost time for Gen Con. I'll see you there, and keep gaming.